Previously, we have done step one of the proof of transversality homotopic theorem. That is, given a smooth map F from a manifold M here to a manifold N, we have extended it to a family. This family that we constructed is transversal to every submanifold of N. Now let's move on to the second step. This step is going to be a bit anticlimactic compared to the previous step. In this step, we claim that any two function in this family are going to be homotopic. This holds true for any family that are indexed by a connected set S. So in particular, it holds for the family we constructed in step 1, because for that step, we took S to be an open ball. Okay, so let's assume that S is connected, and let's take two members of this family. Say we take the map FS1 and FS2, and let's show that they are homotopic. Now, because S is connected, so in particular it must be path connected, thus there must be a path between S1 and S2, i.e. there must be some continuous map gamma from the unit interval into this product S times M, such that gamma 0 is S1 and gamma 1 is S2. Then that means gamma times identity is a continuous map from this product, right, into this S times M. So if we compose that with F, then we get a homotopy connecting FS1 and FS2. Thus, any two maps in this family must be homotopic. In particular, every map in this family must be homotopic to our original map, little F. Now, it remains to show that at least one of the maps in this family must be transversal to the given manifold Z. Actually, we'll show something stronger. We'll show that most maps in this family are going to be transversal to this given submanifold Z. So we'll do that in the next video.